Hey, everybody. Today's weather felt marvelous compared to what was a very snowy weekend across the valley. Still picking up our snow, as you saw in the stories earlier. Right now, here's a look at what's going on at Hector International. Your temperature 30 degrees still. Wind fairly light, but just over 10 miles per hour. It is from the west, so it does have a little bite to it out there. If you get caught in the wind, make sure you're bundling up. Here is a look across the region. 32 Valley City, 32 in Devil's Lake, Jamestown at 37 degrees. Now, looking out to the east, it is a little cooler there. It's 28 for the Bemidji area. Your temperature is a little slower to warm up today across Minnesota. With this, some cloud cover that's been working its way through your area. There it is. It's dissipating now as it pushes us into the eastern half of Minnesota. Just a few clouds starting to show up on the satellite imagery in the James River Valley and Cheyenne River Valley, but most of us enjoying some pretty quiet conditions. Looking at the big picture, there's no big snow systems upstream for us, so it looks like a quiet stretch ahead. That's good. While it is snowing through the Ohio River Valley, Cincinnati getting a snow shot just to the north and east of them. For us tonight, it's going to be quiet. We'll have that west wind continuing. It'll be a little on the breezy side, and that keeps our temperatures from getting too low. We'll stay near 30 degrees all the way till bedtime tonight. Now, as we take a look at the overnight forecast, there'll be a chance for some patchy areas of fog. That's Hutch's only concern with our weather picture as we go through the overnight hours. Best chance will be up in north central Minnesota down into central Minnesota. So patchy areas of fog. We could see some setting up in the James River Valley as well, but I do believe that west wind that we have here in Fargo, the longer that stays high, that's going to keep the fog from developing too strong and too widespread. So just patchy areas. So we start out our day, temperatures will be on the rise. Once again, we'll see a little bit of sunshine, but by late in the day, the clouds increase, and that'll be different than what we saw today in most areas. And as the clouds move in, I left the fog in there because we'll have some winds shifting directions just a bit later in the day, becoming southerly ahead of this weather maker, and it will bring a little more moisture in the area. So at the very least, we'll have some low clouds heading into our Wednesday evening. And those low clouds look like they could yield some flakes of snow for our Northern Valley viewers as we look from the international border into portions of northwest Minnesota. For Fargo, for Grand Forks, it looks dry, although you will see more clouds. Hour by hour forecast, 24 to start. Sunshine abundant in the early three quarters of the day. That's going to allow us to warm up once again to above average temperatures for your hump day. Sunset 4:39 p.m. and then the clouds move in. I don't think we'll see any flakes from them, but the clouds are a result of the south winds blowing into the area. Your hometown forecast, it looks like 30 degrees in Gwinner, 28 for Valley City and Langdon, 26. Grand Forks tomorrow, 27, beautiful degrees. We'll be in the upper 20s once again in northwest and west central Minnesota Lakes Country with Fergus Falls basking in 30 degree beauty. And then this nonsense takes hold. Take a look up north. This is a cold Arctic air mass. Anything forming over north of the Arctic Circle is by definition an Arctic air mass. It's getting no sunlight now, and that makes it really cold. By the time we get through next the week and into the weekend, that cold air mass starts working its way southward, and this is what happens to your temperatures. Well, I'll show you that later. I guess I got I skipped my 7-day planner. I'll have that at the end of your show, you guys. I promise you, you'll want to make sure you know where your long johns are, and you'll want to make sure you know where your plugger inners for your vehicles are, because it's going to get really cold as we go into next weekend.
That cold, huh?
Yes.
All right. Thanks, Josh. Yeah.